Hello children, welcome to the class. We are doing lesson number 4, that is multiplication. As I told you in my previous video also, that multiplication is the process of bringing together groups of equal size. Okay, that means it gives the result of combining groups of equal size, and the result which we get by bringing together two groups is known as the product. Then I told you about multiplication by grouping and multiplication on number line. Today I'll be telling you about multiplication as repeated addition. Yesterday I told you that multiplication is repeated addition. Today I will explain the same in detail. Now see the example. Add 8 4 times. You have to add 8 4 times. That means you have to make 4 groups of 8. 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 is equal to 32. So instead of adding 8 4 times, we can multiply it by 4. Instead of adding 8 4 times, we can multiply it by 4. So 4 into 8 is equal to 32. If you memorize the table till 9, then you can do any multiplication. If you memorize the table till 9, then you can do any multiplication. Okay, so instead of adding 8 4 times, we are multiplying 8 by 4. So 4 into 8 is equal to 32. Now see on this grid, we have to add 4 times. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Then we are again adding 8. That means we are counting forward 8 times more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We reach 16. Then again counting 8 more numbers. We are reaching 24. And then again counting 8. We are reaching 32. That means when we add 8 4 times, we get 32. So instead of adding 8 4 times, we can simply multiply it by 4. Okay. So this is, since we are adding one number many times, we say that multiplication is repeated addition. Repeated means to repeat something. Kisi cheez ko bar bar dohrana. Since here we are adding one number many times, we are repeating the same number. So therefore, multiplication is also known as repeated addition. Now see this. Fill in the placeholders using number grid. Okay. Now, okay. Now add, here we have to add 9 5 times. Okay. So, first we count 9 and we reach here. This is 9. Okay. Then again we count 9 and we reach at 18. Then again we count 9, we reach at 27. Then again we count 9, we reach at 36. Again we count 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, we reach 45. So adding 9 5 times, what do we get? We get 45. Okay. So here, since we are adding 9 5 times, we can also say 5 into 9 is equal to 45. Okay. So you can say that when we add 9 5 times, we get 45, or when we multiply 9 by 5, since we are adding 9 5 times, we get 45. Okay. Now see this example. Add 5 6 times. Here you have to add 5 6 times. Okay. Now let us take a color. Now add 5 6 times. First we count 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we reach here. Then again we count 5, we add 5 more, we reach 10. Then we again Add 5 more times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We reach 15. Then again add 5. We reach 20. And again we add 5. We reach 25. Again we add 5. We reach 30. So when we add 5, 6 times, we get 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. We get 30. So instead of adding 5 6 times, we can also write 6 into 5 is equal to 30. Okay. So this is repeated addition. We are repeating one number many times to make the addition. Okay. So instead of adding, it is more easier multiplying a number. Instead of adding a number many times, it is easier to multiply that number by the number of times we are adding it. Okay. Now suppose you have to add a number many times. Here you are adding it 5 times, 6 times, 4 times. So you can add it. But suppose you have to add a number many times. Say suppose you have to add a number 12 times or 13 times. So you can make mistakes. You can tend to make mistakes since you are adding one number many times. You can make mistakes. But if you multiply that number by the number of times you are adding it, we will not make any mistake. Chances of making a mistake will be lesser. We can make mistake. Of course, if you don't remember the table, then definitely you can make mistake. But chances of making mistakes is lesser. Many times it so happens that if they don't remember the table, then they add, suppose they have to do 7 into 9. So they add 9 7 times and write the correct answer. But if you remember the table, then you can immediately write 7 into 9 is equal to 63. It saves the time also. It is easier and it is quicker also. Okay. Now see this. Match the correct answer. 7 plus 7 plus 7 is equal to 21. And here in multiplication, which answer will give you 21? 3 into 7. So we will match this with this. 4 plus 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. And here which answer will give you 8? 2 into 4. 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. That is 30. And here 5, 6 are 30. So this is matching. Okay, now we will do the multiplication tables. First is multiplication table of 6. See on the left hand side and see on the right hand side. On the left hand side, you will find blocks of 6. 1 6's are 6. That is adding 1 6 times, you get 6. Okay, so 1 6's are 6 and you write it as 1 multiplied by 6 is equal to 6. I told you that the symbol of multiplication is this, into. Symbol of addition is plus, symbol of subtraction is this, and symbol of multiplication is this. Okay, so we write it as 1 6's are 6. And we write it as 1 into 6 is equal to 6. That is 1 6's, 1 block of 6. Okay. Now 2 times 2 6's are 12. 2 6's are 12 means 2 times 6's. 2 groups of 6's are 12. In my previous video also, I told you that when we write multiplication as grouping, we always write the number of group first. Okay. So 2 into 6 means 2 groups of 6. 3 into 6 means 3 groups of 6. So here 1 group of 6, that is 1 into 6 is equal to 6. Then you can see 6 plus 6. 2 6's are 12. That means 2 groups of 6's are 12. So we write it as 2 into 6 is equal to 12. Then 6 plus 6 plus 6. 3 6's are 18. That means 3 groups of 6 are 18. And we write it as 3 into 6 is equal to 18. Now 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6, that means 4 6's are 24. That is 4 groups of 6's are 24, and we write it as 4 into 6 is equal to 24. The next is 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. 5 6's are 30. That is 5 times 6's are 30. Okay, so 5 into 6 is equal to 30. Then 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. So 6 sixes are 36. That means 6 groups of 6s are 36. So we write it as 6 into 6 is equal to 30. The next is 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6 plus 6. That is 7 sixes are 42. That means 7 groups of 6s are 42. So it is 7 sixes are 42. Next is 8 sixes are 48. That means 8 groups of 6s are 48. So we write it as 8 into 6 is equal to 48. Then 9 sixes are 54. That means 9 groups of 6s are 54. So 9 into 6 is equal to 54. And then 10 sixes are 60. That means 10 groups of 6s are 60. You can count the number of groups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 groups of 6s are 60. So this is 10 into 6 is equal to 60. So this is the multiplication table of 6. Okay. You can see this is repeated addition. 6, then add 6 2 times, then add 6 3 times, then add 6 4 times, then add 6 5 times, then add 6 6 times, then 7 times, then 8 times, then add 6 9 times, and then add 6 10 times. Similarly, we can add 6 11 times, 12 times, 13 times, 14 times, any number of times. There is no end to numbers. So this is how we write multiplication table. So next is multiplication table of 7. Okay. Now see this. Same thing. One group of 7. 1 7s are 7. That is one group of 7 is 7. So 1 into 7 is equal to 7. 2 7s are 14. That is two groups of 7 are 14. So we write 2 7s are 14. Then 3 7s are 21. 3 groups of 7s are 21. 3 into 7 is equal to 21. 4 7s are 28. That is 4 groups of 7s are 28. 4 7s are 28. 5 7s are 35. 5 7s means 5 groups of 7s. 5 groups of 7s are 35. So we write it as 5 into 7. Since we always write the number of group first. So 1 group, 2 group, 3 group, 4 group, 5 group, 6 group. And number of object in each group remains the same. Since this is multiplication of 7. Since therefore number of anything, any object you take, any thing you can take, that will remain the same in each group. That will remain 7 only in each group. Since this is the multiplication of table, only the number of group will change. Then 6 7s are 42. That means 6 groups of 7s are 42. So 6 into 7 is equal to 42. Then 7 7s are 49. 7 groups of 7s are 49. Therefore, 7 into 7 is equal to 49. Then 8 7s are 56. That is 8 groups of 7s are 56. So 8 into 7 is equal to 56. Then 9 7s are 63. That is 9 groups of 7s are 63. So 9 into 7 is equal to 63. Then 10 7s are 70. That is 10 groups of 7s are 70. Therefore, 10 into 7 is equal to 70. Next, multiplication table of 8. Again here, the number of group will change. Since this is multiplication table of 8, the number of objects in each group will remain the same. That is 8. Only the number of group will change. 1 8s are 8. That is 1 group of 8 is 8. So 1 into 8 is equal to 8. Second, 2 groups of 8s are 16. So 2 into 8 is equal to 16. 3 groups of 8s are 24. So 3 into 8 is equal to 24. 4 groups of 8s are 32. So 4 into 8 is equal to 32. 5 8s are 40. That is 5 into 8 is equal to 40. 6 8s are 48. So 6 into 8 is equal to 48. 7 8s are 56, so 7 into 8 is equal to 56. 8 groups of 8s are 64, therefore 8 into 8 is equal to 64. 9 groups of 8s are 72, that is 9 into 8 is equal to 72. And 10 8s are 80, that is 10 into 8 is equal to 80. So you can see we are adding the same number once, twice, three times, four times, five times, six times, seven times, eight times, nine times and 10 times. So this is multiplication table and this is multiplication as repeated addition. Here on the left side, it is multiplication as repeated addition, and the same thing can be shown as multiplication table. Same thing can be shown as multiplication. Now, multiplication table of 9, again here only the number of groups will change and the number of objects in each group will remain the same, that is 9, since it is the multiplication table of 9. So, one group of 9s are 9, that is 1 into 9 is equal to 9. Two groups of 9s are 18, so 2 into 9 is equal to 18. Then, three groups of 9s are 27, 3 9s are 27. Four groups of 9s are 36, so 4 into 9 is equal to 36. Then, five 9s are 45, that is 5 into 9 is equal to 45. 6 groups of 9s are 54, so 6 9s are 54. 7 groups of 9s are 63, so 7 9s are 63. Then 8 groups of 9s are 72, so 8 into 9 is equal to 72. Then 9 groups of 9s are 81, so 9 9s are 81. And 10 groups of 9s are 90, so 10 9s are 90. So again here on the left side, where the blocks are there, you can see that it is shown as repeated addition. And on the right hand side, you can see that same thing is shown as multiplication. Answer is same in both the cases. If you count the number of objects in each box, you will get the same answer. 9 plus 9 is 18, 2 into 9 18. 9 plus 9 plus 9 is 27, 3 into 9 is 27. So this is how we can show multiplication as repeated addition. Now see the multiplication table of 10. One group of 10 is 10, so 1 tens are 10. Two groups of 10s are 20, so 2 into 10 is equal to 20. Three groups of 10 are 30, so 3 into 10 is equal to 30. Four groups of 10s are 40, so 4 into 10 is equal to 40. Five groups of 10s are 50, so 5 into 10 is equal to 50. 6 groups of 10s are 60, so 6 into 10 is equal to 60. 7 groups of 10s are 70, so 7 into 10 is equal to 70. 8 groups of 10s are 80, so 8 into 10 is equal to 80. 9 groups of 10s are 90, so it is 9 into 10 is equal to 90. And 10 groups of 10s are 100, so it is 10 into 10 is equal to 100. So adding 10 times or multiplying 10 by 10 gives the same answer, that is 100. Adding 10 9 times or multiplying 10 by 90 gives the same answer, that is 90. Adding 10 8 times or multiplying 10 by 8 gives the same answer, that is 80. Adding 10 7 times or multiplying 10 by 7 gives the same result, that is 70. So, this is why we say multiplication as repeated addition. Multiplication as repeated addition only when the number is same. When we are adding the same number many times. 9 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6, we cannot call it repeated addition. Okay, because all the numbers are different. Only when the number is same, we add a number many times, we add the same number many times, then only we say it is repeated addition. So, multiplication tables are repeated addition. Okay, so that is why it is said that multiplication is repeated addition. Okay, now complete the table. You can see numbers from 1 to 10 horizontally written and numbers from 1 to 10 vertically written. Now here you have to multiply the number. Now see, in multiplication, when you are multiplying two numbers, when you are writing multiplication as group, then it is mandatory that you write the number of group first. If you write 3 into 5, that means 3 groups of 5 objects. Okay, so 3 into 5 is 15, 5 into 3 is also 15, but 3 into 5 means 3 groups of 5 items and 5 into 3 means 5 groups of 3 items. So, when we write multiplication as group, we always write the number of group first. Okay, but otherwise when you multiply two numbers, you can multiply in either way. If you have to multiply 3 by 5, you can write 3 into 5 or you can write 5 into 3 because answer is same as in addition. When we add two or more than two numbers, changing the order does not change the answer. 2 plus 3 plus 4 is equal to 9. Okay? 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. So even if you write 3 plus 2 plus 4, it will give you the same answer 9. 4 plus 2 plus 3, it will give you the same answer 9. Okay, so changing the order of the number does not change the result. Similarly, in multiplication also, since multiplication is repeated addition, so in multiplication also, if you change the order of the numbers, the result will remain the same. This is when we are multiplying two numbers or more than two numbers. So 2 into 4 is 8, 4 into 2 is 8. This is when we are multiplying, when we are doing simple multiplication. Okay, so here what you have to do is, you can multiply, you have to multiply the first number of each row, the first number of the row by each number of the column, that is 1 into 1 is equal to, let me show you. One into one is equal to one. One into two, two. One into three, three. One into four, four. One into five, five. One into six, six. One into seven, seven. One into eight, eight. One into nine, nine. And one into ten, ten. Similarly, you have to multiply the next number by each number. Two ones are two. Two twos are four. 2 3s are 6, 2 4s are 8, 2 5s are 10. Similarly, you have to multiply. You can do it like this way, or you can take this number and then multiply 1 by all the numbers and write here. Multiply 2 by all the numbers. See, 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3, or 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3. If you multiply like this, 1 2s are 2, 2 1s are 2. 2 2's are 4, 2 2's are 4. 3 into 1, 3, 3 2's are 6, 2 3's are 6. So, when you are multiplying two numbers, you can multiply them anyway. 7 into 6, 6 into 7. The answer will remain the same. So, in multiplication, if we change the order of the number, the answer does not change, it remains the same. As like in addition. So, you can multiply it. Anyway, first is the multiplication table from 1 to 10, and in second grid, you have to multiply the numbers. Let us take 6 5s are 30. Okay, so you can multiply 6 by 5, you can multiply 5 by 6, the answer will remain the same. 6 2s are 12, or 2 6s are 12. 6 9s are 54, or 9 6 are 54. Okay, 7 2s are 14, or 2 7s are 14. So, in this manner, you have to complete the grid. Either you can take the number, first number, second number, third number, fourth number, column wise, and then multiply by each number horizontally, or you can take each number in the row and multiply each number in the column. The answer will remain the same. As I have shown you, 6 5s are 30, 6 2s are 12, 6 1s are 6, 6 7s are 42, 6 9s are 54, 6 10s are 60, 6 6s are 36, 6 8s are 48, 6 4s are 24, 6 3s are 18. Or you multiply like this, 5 6s are 30, 2 6s are 12, 1 6s are 6, 7 6s are 42, 9 6 are 54, 10 6 are 60, 6 6 are 36, 8 6 are 48, 4 6 are 24, 3 6 are 18. The answer will remain the same. So, when we change the order of the number in multiplication, we get the same product. Only in when we write addition, multiplication as grouping, we always write the number of groups first. So, today I'll stop here, children. In my next video, I will solve some multiplication stories, and then I will explain multiplication column wise, like we have done vertical addition, vertical subtraction. Now we will be doing vertical multiplication also. I will explain that in my next video. Thank you, children. Now see, children, how I'll tell you how do we complete the table. As I've told you earlier also, if we change the order of the number in multiplication, the product remains the same. Whether you multiply 6 by 5 or 5 by 6, The product is 30 only. 6 5s are 30. That means 6 groups of 5s are 30. And 5 6s are 30. That means 5 groups of 6 are 30. So, in multiplication, changing the order of the numbers does not change the product. Okay? So, we can write 5 into 6 or we can write 6 into 5. Now, I will show you how do we do it. Either you can first take the numbers column wise. That means you first take 6 and then multiply this 6 by all the numbers given in this row. That means 6 into 5, then 6 into 2, then 6 multiplied by 1, then 6 multiplied by 7, then 6 multiplied by 9, then 6 multiplied by 10, then 6 multiplied by 6, then 6 multiplied by 8, 6 multiplied by 4, or 6 multiplied by 3. Okay, so you will get the answer. Or you can do 5 into 6, then 5 into 3, 5 into 5, 5 multiplied by 1, 5 multiplied by 4, 5 multiplied by 8, 5 multiplied by 9, 5 multiplied by 7, 5 multiplied by 2, 5 multiplied by 10. Okay, so or you can take then 3 multiplied by 5, 3 into 2, 3 multiplied by 1, 3 multiplied by 7, 3 multiplied by 9, 3 multiplied by 10, 3 multiplied by 6, 3 multiplied by 8, 3 multiplied by 3, 3 multiplied by 4. Okay, so what you can do is you can take any number column wise first and then multiply that number by all the numbers in this row. Or you can take any number or you can take the numbers in this row and then multiply it by all the numbers in the column. You will get the same answer. Suppose I take 8. Okay. 8. So 8 5s are 40. 8 2s are 16. 8 1s are 8. 8 7s are 56. 8 9s are 72. 8 10s are 80. 8 6s are 48. 8 8s are 64. 8 4s are 32. And 8 3s are 24. Okay. Then if you multiply 5 by 8, you get 40. 2 8s are 16. 1 8s are 8. 7 8s are 56. 9 8s are 72. 10 8s are 80. 6 8s are 48. 8 8s are 64. 4 8s are 32. And 3 8s are 24. So you get the same product, same answer. Okay. So if we change the order of the numbers in multiplication, the product remains the same. Only when we write multiplication as grouping, then we have to follow a particular pattern. In multiplication by group, 3 multiplied by 5 means 3 group of 5 numbers. Total we will get the same. 3 into 5 is equal to 15, which means 3 groups of 5 numbers. And 5 into 3, the answer is same, 15. But 5 multiplied by 3 means 5 groups of 3 objects. And 3 into 5 means 3 groups of 5 objects. There are 3 groups and 5 objects in each group. And 5 into 3 means there are 5 groups and 3 objects in each group. So, answer will remain the same. Total will remain the same, 15. But we have to write the number of group first. But in multiplication, even if we change the order of the numbers, our product remains the same. So in this manner, you can do This also complete the table. Here also I'll show you one. See, you can either take one column wise and then multiply this one by all the numbers in this row, or you can take one in the row and then multiply one by all the numbers in this column. So let us take this one. Okay, so 1 1s are 1, 1 2s are 2, 1 3s are 3, 1 4s are 4, 1 5s are 5, 1 6s are 6, 1 7s are 7, 1 8s are 8, 1 9s are 9, 1 10s are 10. Okay, now let us take 4 here. Okay, 4, and then multiply this 4 by all the numbers in this column. 4 1s are 4. So here you multiplied 1 4s are 4, and here you are multiplying 4 1s are 4. Okay, the answer is same. 4 2s are 8, 4 3s are 12. This is the multiplication table of 1 to 10. 4 4s are 16, 4 5s are 20, 4 6s are 24, 4 7s are 28. So 4 7s are 28, or you multiply 7 by 4, you get 28. So product is same, changing the order of the numbers in multiplication does not make any difference. The answer is the same. Okay, so we have done the multiplication table from 6 to 10. We will revise it once again. 6 1s are 6. 1 into 6 is equal to 6. 2 6 are 12. 3 6 are 18. 4 6 are 24. 5 6 are 30. 6 6 are 36. 7 6 are 42. 8 6 are 48. 9 6 are 54. 10 6 are 60. 1 7 are 7. 2 7 are 14. 3 7 are 21. 4 7s are 28, 5 7s are 35, 6 7s are 42, 7 7s are 49, 8 7s are 56, 9 7s are 63, 10 7s are 70. Then 1 8s are 8, 2 8s are 16, 3 8s are 24, 4 8s are 32, 5 8s are 40, 6 8s are 48, 7 8s are 56, 8 8s are 64, 9 8s are 72, 10 8s are 80. 1 9s are 9. 2 9s are 18. 3 9s are 27. 4 9s are 36. 5 9s are 45. 6 9s are 54. 7 9s are 63. 8 9s are 72. 9 9s are 81. 10 9s are 90. Then 1 10s are 10. 2 10s are 20. 3 10s are 30. 4 10s are 40, 5 10s are 50, 6 10s are 60, 7 10s are 70, 8 10s are 80, 9 10s are 90, and 10 10s are 100. When we say the multiplication table, we say it 9 1s are 9, 9 2s are 18, 9 3s are 27. That means 9 groups of 1 are 9, 9 2s are 18 means 9 groups of 2s are 18. 9 3s are 27 means 9 groups of 3s are 27. This is not correct in context of multiplication table. In multiplication table, number of objects in each group remains the same. Only the number of group keep changing. If it is a multiplication table of 9, then the objects in each group will remain 9 only. Only the number of group will change. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we cannot restrict, we do not restrict it till 10 only. Generally, when we memorize the table, we memorize till 10, but you can proceed. 10 9s are 90, 11 9s are 99, 12 9s are 108, 13 9s are 14 9s are 15 9s are 16 9s are, there is no end to the counting. Okay, so in multiplication table, the number of objects, if it is a multiplication table of 7, then number of objects in each group will remain 7 only. Only the number of group will change. If it is multiplication table of 8, the number of objects in each group will remain 8 only. Only the number of group will keep changing. Okay, and when we multiply two numbers, if we change their order, the product does not change, the product remains the same. Okay, children, so I'll stop here now. Thank you.